Bueno, aquí estamos en una de las últimas entrevistas desde el Twitter Blue Room en IAB Conecta 2018. Soy Paula Cutulli de Social Media Week junto con la Universidad de la Comunicación. Y ahora vamos a cambiar a English. With Gary Makigian, CEO co-founder de Travel Music.
Travel Music.
Yes. So, tell me, what is Travel Music, please?
So Travel Music is the so far the only free music download platform in the world that's sponsored by brand advertising, where you can get free music downloaded onto your mobile device so you can listen to it offline and off screen.
Great. So it's like very easy to access for the younger generations and people who are not very connected. That was kind of the purpose of doing this.
Yes. So if you think about the music listening audience,
yes,
in Mexico, for example,
yes,
60 million smartphone owners. Most of these smartphone owners are young people. They're 13, 14, 18, 20 years old, 25, right? And only 2.5-3 million smartphone owners have the ability to pay for music.
Yes.
The question is, what's everybody else doing, right? Where are they getting their music? Because music is not, music is a necessity. Everybody needs to have their favorite music on their device. We created a service for those people who cannot afford to pay for music.
So what about your presence here in IAB Conecta? What did you make the audience learn about this platform, or how do you relate with this digital environment of advertising and IAB?
So our platform is designed to generate income for the artists.
Okay.
Right? So it's important for music fans to listen to the favorite music, you know, on their device, but it's also important for the artists to get compensated fairly for the
music.
Because
if not,
this
public that couldn't pay will be like doing pirate things and all this.
Exactly, which is probably what's happening right now, right?
Okay.
So now we're reaching out to our audience and saying, you don't have to take the music where the artist does not get compensated. You can use Treble to get the music that you want. And we're talking to brand advertisers now saying, this is a good way to create with your audience, who is increasingly very young and very mobile, and tell them about your products, right? So the reason I'm here today is because there are a lot of brand advertisers who want to learn about how they can use music to advertise their products, how to do brand advertising using music. And so I was here talking to them about the various ways they can place brand advertising into our product that does not interfere with the customers, with the users' music listening experience.
Oh, that's great, because something that we have been talking about with a lot of speakers,
yes,
and like the last trends is how to create a connection with the audience, with the content that they are consuming and not invading them, because we need to communicate, brands need to communicate in a different way.
That's right.
And advertising is changing. That's why we are all here learning.
That's right. Yeah, see, the nice thing about the mobile generation is they're okay with consuming advertising, but they want to consume advertising when they're ready for it.
Yeah.
They don't want to consume advertising when they're in the middle of listening to their favorite music, for example.
Yeah.
Because in our opinion, that can actually create negative brand value.
Yeah.
Right?
Exactly.
When I'm listening and I'm
I'm
in the zone.
You're in the zone, exactly.
Yeah, I don't want to listen to advertising, but when I'm searching for music, when I'm downloading music, when I'm building my playlist, these are all time-consuming tasks on our platform. This is a good time to deliver advertising to the users, and this is what we're doing.
Okay. Well, great to share your experience. Where are you from?
I am from Armenia, and I live in the United States.
Okay. Where?
And in Los Angeles.
In Los Angeles.
Yes, I'm from Los Angeles. And I also want to mention that my daughters will kill me if I don't mention this, because they're going to see this. I want to mention that they are my co-founders. I have a 18-year-old and a 21-year-old who started this company with me 4 years ago when they were 14 and 17, 18.
That's an amazing story.
Yeah.
You must be all proud of having this family amazing business.
Grace and Juliet, I'm proud of them.
And to connect generations in it.
That's right.
That's nice.
And it's music. And kids
it's
love
music.
Right?
Exactly. What better way?
Right.
So cool daddy you must be.
Well, I'd like to think
I hope
so.
They say that.
I hope I stay cool.
That's good. That's good. So this is your first time in Mexico?
I come to Mexico often because one of our most important partners is Televisa.
Okay.
And so we're trying to create a commercial relationship with Televisa.
Okay.
Because they are also trying to reach their audience. That's 13, 15, 18, 25. And
the tricky audience, we all want them.
Exactly. We all want them, and music is one of the best ways to get them.
Exactly. Okay, well, thank you very much, Gary,
for being
here. It was a pleasure to meet you.
Nice talking to you.
Thank you. Y bueno, ya en las últimas entrevistas nos vemos en un ratito. Gracias.
Thank you.